Hey guys, how's it going? It's Dan Cohn here. Welcome back to the Overwatch League Roundup. Stage 4, Week 3 Preview. So, last week was a thing that happened, and we had some really, really weird results. But it's time to take a look at Week 3. And Week 3 should be interesting, because we've got some matchups that some teams really, really need to win. And it'll be a big tester for some teams as well. So, if we look at our starting fixtures, Friday, August the 9th is when we'll kick off. It'll be a midnight BST or 1 a.m. in Europe, and it's a biggie. It's London Spitfire taking on the Vancouver Titans. Now, London at the start of last week looked good, and then London did what they did against Florida, and then Vancouver did what they did against Washington, so who knows where these two teams are at right now. A lot of question marks over both. The thing is, I know London Spitfire too well. London, I think what happened against Florida is London being London, and London will not take this game as lightly as they did the Florida game. Nor will the Titans, though, so this is difficult. They both got DPS lineups that can pop off, like really pop off, so this is so hard to call, dude. So hard to call, but can Vancouver really go with two losses on the bounce? Don't know. I don't think anyone would expect it, but yeah, we'll see. So, moving on after that match, we have the Paris Eternal taking on the Philadelphia Fusion. So, Fusion, although they got two wins last week, I still don't have the confidence I had in the Fusion come the end of last year. So, I think this is winnable for the Paris Eternal. I think this is actually winnable. Whether they will win or not? Paris. Paris are just enormously inconsistent. This could be a really close match at 1:45 a.m. or 2:45 in Europe. It's a really, really close match, but I think Fusion should be able to get it past Paris Eternal. Paris, this inconsistency bugs me a lot. Moving on after that, at 3:30 or 4:30 in Europe, we have the Toronto Defiant taking on the Florida Mayhem. So, two teams off the back of shock wins last week. Toronto beating Shanghai and Florida beating the London Spitfire. Florida looked better, but are they good enough? I think Toronto will still beat Florida. I think they will. It will be a close match, I think. But I think Toronto's tank line will beat out the Florida Mayhem. And I think the DPS lineups are fairly evenly matched. Logics can pop off. Sire player can pop off. I think Mangachu might be a key player for the Toronto Defiant in that match, but I think Toronto will win nonetheless. 5:15 or 6:15 in Europe, we have the Guangzhou Charge taking on the Salt Dynasty. Interesting. Guangzhou Charge, they bounced back well against the Hangzhou Spark after losing to London Spitfire. I don't have worries about the Guangzhou Charge. I think Guangzhou Charge will beat the Seoul Dynasty. I think Seoul are a bit inconsistent for my liking for me to back them to beat the Charge. I think Charge will be fairly consistent. They came up against the only loss they've got this stage. They came up against a really, really well-prepared London Spitfire side. Really well-prepared, and it cost the Spitfire in the second game of that week, as we know. So I wouldn't be too downhearted losing 3-1 to the Spitfire in the way they did. But it is a very winnable game for Guangzhou Charge, and it is the only game they play this week, so they can wholly and solely concentrate on preparing for the Seoul Dynasty, whereas Seoul will also have to prepare for Toronto Defiant as well. So I think that's really winnable for Charge, and I will back them to win. Moving on, Saturday, August the 10th at midnight or 1 a.m. in Europe, we have the Boston Uprising taking on the Washington Justice. Boston are still in with a chance, but it's a very, very slim chance at this point. And the way Washington have looked this stage, I think Washington win that. I think the DPS lineup for the Washington Justice is better than Florida's, is better than Boston's, is better than Toronto's. I think it's better than Paris's at the moment. So I think Washington will beat the Boston Uprising purely on DPS lineup alone. The tank lines, I would back Boston, but the thing is, the things that are making the difference right now are DPS, and that I have to give to Washington Justice. So I think the Washington Justice will beat the Boston Uprising. That would be bad news for Boston. This is a must-win game for Boston, as simple as that. But pretty much every game is for Boston now. 1:45 a.m. or 2:45 in Europe, we have the Dallas Fuel taking on the Los Angeles Gladiators. I don't think this will be close. I think the Gladiators should get a fairly comfortable win over the Fuel. It's a difficult week for the Fuel. It's a really difficult week for the Fuel, and they needed to get wins back in the past 2 weeks, and they haven't got them. So, yeah, things are not getting any easier for the Dallas Fuel. And at the moment, the only way I can see for them is down. Unfortunately. It's unfortunate. I don't even think Taimu will be able to carry them to a win over the Gladiators. The Gladiators, though, should be able to further seal themselves in those playoff spots. Moving on, 3:30 or 4:30 in Europe, we have the San Francisco Shock taking on the Shanghai Dragons. I would go for a Shock win here, simply because Shanghai Dragons, as much as we loved their DPS in Stage 3, don't seem to have adjusted to the roll lock very well. They could pull off an upset against the Shock, but I think it's more unlikely than it was. So I would go for the Shock to get a fairly comfortable victory over the Shanghai Dragons, like a 3-1. It's unfortunate for Shanghai because it's a game they kind of perhaps need to win now, but it's not the end of the world if Shanghai still lose. Moving on, at 5:15 or 6:15 in New York, we have the Hangzhou Spark taking on the New York Excelsior. Talking about teams that haven't adapted to the 2-2 meta very well, Hangzhou Spark are yet to win a game this stage. And I don't think that changes here. Hangzhou, they just look completely out of sorts. It could be 2-2, it could be also the situation with Crystal. It's not brilliant for Spark, it's really not, but they have to start working it out of their system and getting wins on the ball, because otherwise they're going to give up their playoff spot, because there are teams hunting. Yes, they've dropped some games, but they are still hunting, and this is where the fixtures for the Hangzhou Sparks start to pick up now. They got 2 games this week, and they probably got 2 games in week 4 as well. So they really need to start putting wins on the board, Spark. And you really don't want to go into the playoffs with a downwards trend in your momentum, because not always good. New York Excelsior, I would expect them to get past them, but again, they lost 4-0 to the Chengdu Hunters. So who knows? If Spark finds something quirky that catches the Excelsior out, it could go completely the opposite way. Moving on. 8 p.m. or 9 p.m. in Europe, we have the Houston Outlaws taking on the London Spitfire. Now, if you go on form tables, you go on the paper stats of each team, London Spitfire should win this one quite comfortably, but I said that about the Florida Mayhem, so I can eat words very easily. One thing that does go in the Outlaws' favour is last season, Outlaws were a big bogey team for the London Spitfire, in a similar meta to what we are seeing now. So Outlaws could pick up an upset here, but I would still back London to squeeze through in the end. Although, if they are forced to a map 5, remember that map 5 is control. I will never back London on control, because they look very bad on control. So London, big tip is, avoid map 5s. Get your 3-1s, get your 4-0s. Get your 2-1s, get your 2-0s, get whatever. Just don't go to map 5, because I think they will lose in a 3-2. Moving on, 9:45 or 10:45 in Europe, we have the Seoul Dynasty taking on the Toronto Defiant. Big banana skin for the Seoul Dynasty. Big banana skin. Toronto upwards trend right now. I think it kind of depends for Toronto what happens against Florida. If Toronto carry the momentum going through and beat Florida, the momentum might keep going and they might get a sneaky win over the Seoul Dynasty, but I will still back the Seoul Dynasty. I think they are slightly better than the Toronto Defiant. I think we can say that. And providing Seoul can play like they should be able to, they should be able to see off the Toronto Defiant quite easily. But it's an upset potential. It's an upset potential. And if there's anything, we need to make sure we outline upset potentials, because last week showed us a lot of them. So moving on, at 11:30 or 12:30 in Europe, we have the Florida Mayhem taking on the Valiant. Los Angeles Valiant should be able to win this one. I don't care what Florida did to London last week. Valiant have 1 game this week against the Mayhem. You should be able to tear the Mayhem apart, Valiant. And this is what you need to do. 4-0 for Valiant would be fantastic here. and exactly what I would expect against the Florida Mayhem. Florida have been getting better, but I don't think they're quite good enough right now to start beating the likes of the upwards trend of Valiant and people like that. So I would expect a Valiant win here. At 1:15 or 2:15 in Europe, we have the Chengdu Hunters taking on the Hangzhou Spark. Hangzhou, above all else, this must be a win. Doesn't matter if you lose to the NYXL earlier in the week, you have to beat the Chengdu Hunters. It's a must-win game for you, because if you lose these two games this week, you've lost four games in a row, and you're already looking at a bad stage. So Hangzhou really need a win against Chengdu if they don't get it against New York, and they still need it even if they do get a win against New York. So the thing is, the chaotic start of the Chengdu Hunters, it really could come and bite the Hangzhou Spark. They need to make sure that they make... I think the key against Chengdu, don't play the meta like New York did, because you will get embarrassed. Play the counter comp. If they go for a Pharah, go for a McCree, or I wouldn't say Soldier 76 because he is trashed here at the moment, but a McCree, a Widow, go for that. Don't go and try and play May Reaper into it, for goodness sake, because you'll get embarrassed. That's my tip. Moving on though, at 8 p.m. or 9 p.m. in Europe, we have the Philadelphia Fusion taking on the Vancouver Titans. Titans have to take on the two finalists from last year this week, and it's quite interesting, isn't it? This, I think, will be a different game to the game against London Spitfire. Regardless of whether Vancouver win or lose against the Spitfire, I think Vancouver should be able to see off the Fusion. I think the Fusion are too badly coordinated right now to take down a team like the Vancouver Titans. I might be wrong. And on the day, if you have an insane game from one of your DPS, say EQO or Carpe, then they could beat anyone in the league. But at the moment, what I've got to work from in front of me, I can only see Titans winning that game. And that's the difference between Philadelphia and London right now. I could see London upsetting the Titans. I don't see Fusion upsetting the Titans. It looks unlikely to me. At 10:15 or 10:45 in Europe, we have the Washington Justice taking on the Houston Outlaws. This is a difficult one. I still think I will back the Washington Justice, simply because Houston, it looked really good at the start of the stage, and yep, right pointing finger, downwards trend. It's not happy. The two Texan teams are really not happy right now, and I think Washington can take advantage of this. I think, despite the potential for Linkser to pop off, I think Corey really does have the Washington Justice on his back right now, and I think Washington will be able to squeeze out a win over the Houston Outlaws. And who would have thought me backing the Washington Justice to win two games in 1 week? But here we are. Stage 4 is really weird. Moving on, at 11:30 or 12:30 in Europe, we have the San Francisco Shock taking on the Dallas Fuel. Again, I think Shock will storm this game. I told you it was a bad week for the Dallas Fuel. If Dallas Fuel can get anything out of this week, then big props to them, because I wouldn't have predicted it. Although, again, take last week as a case study. Dallas Fuel, it can be done. It can be done, but not likely. Dallas Fuel are really one of those teams that are on a downwards trend right now, and I don't see it changing. So I think Shock should be able to comprehensively beat this Dallas Fuel. Moving on, last game of the week at 1:15 on the Monday or 2:15 in Europe. This is an interesting one. Guangzhou Charge taking on the New York Excelsior. So this is a big test of New York and their ability to shut down DPS, right? They have the problem that they have to play Hangzhou Spark also as well this week. If they can do what London did to Guangzhou, New York will win this quite comfortably. If New York pour time into trying to defeat the Spark, basically, what I'm saying in New York is you need to shut down Happy. If you shut down Happy, you'll beat the Charge. If you don't shut down Happy, he will wreck you. Yeah. Charger beatable. London has showed that. New York are also beatable when you throw weird stuff at them. The thing is, I don't think Guangzhou will throw weird stuff at New York Excelsior. I think they will throw the Widow, and every now and then there'll be a Mei or a Hanzo or a Reaper. And New York will look at that and say, yes, we'll play the meta. Thank you very much. We'll take the W. So, I still have to back New York to win this one, but there is an incredible chance for Charge to take the victory over New York Excelsior. It wouldn't surprise me if they did. So, those are your fixtures for week 3. We are really cracking through stage 4 now. I can't believe it's August, to be quite honest with you. We have 2 weeks after this week. 2 weeks. And then we will know who's in the play-ins, who's in the playoffs, and, you know, we will be approaching the end of our season, and we will also be approaching Sigma's debut, perhaps, maybe, in the Overwatch League. But I am going to leave it here for this one. I will be back for the results, no doubt, probably on Monday. But for now, thank you guys so much for watching this video. If you liked it, give it a like, subscribe if you're new, and I will see you in the next video. See you then.